books. So with me now to talk more about all of this, presidential historian Douglas Brinkley. Good to see you. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you.
So we know President Obama is focusing on unfinished business in the new year, his last year, gun control topping the list now. So the last State of the Union, he vowed to use more executive privileges. So what do you expect in his final State of the Union?
Well, he's definitely going to want to try to address the gun issue, as you just mentioned. This is something that's a pet peeve of the president. He's angered by the fact that much of his presidency's had to deal with shootings and a mass killing. So he's trying to find, if Congress won't help him, some executive tools, legal tools that will help him get gun control to be a major part of his legacy in his last year. Also, climate change. This president has put a lot of skin in that game. He got a result out of Paris recently, and now he has to come home and sell climate change to the American public. And I expect those will be the two main thrust of his State of the Union, along with how to defeat ISIL.
Okay. And, you know, when you look at recent polling and 50% say that they have an unfavorable view of the president, will it be important to the president to try to turn those numbers around in 2016? How much of his legacy is shaped by that kind of sentiment?
Well, it's a good question. I mean, Ronald Reagan used to say you don't want to have a box office that goes below 50%. If he could hover at 50, he probably would be satisfied with that. But I'm afraid that unless things get better dealing in the war on terror, anytime there's a strike anywhere, anytime we have a situation like Paris or San Bernardino, people in some ways blame the president for some kind of security breach or the fact that he wasn't working close enough with our allies on the war on terror. And it's going to be hard to keep his 50 going. But do not think Barack Obama's presidency's over, that he's a complete lame duck. The very fact is Hillary Clinton's going to need him on the Democratic Party. I mean, Barack Obama has about a 90% or more, 95% approval rating with African Americans. He needs to generate that vote, and he has his fans within the Democratic Party. There are Obama Democrats, so can he start bringing out the vote for Hillary Clinton, particularly in urban settings, places like Cincinnati or Tampa, Miami? It will be very interesting to see as the year turns into the fall.
Mm-hmm. And many argue about whether polling is, you know, is that important, but when it does come to the satisfaction with the U.S. and how it's being governed, there is this polling that says only 24% say they are satisfied. How is the president to interpret this? You know, is it a reflection of how he is governing or how the White House and Congress are not working together?
I mean, if you're President Barack Obama and if you do see polls you don't like, the way you make yourself feel better is then go look at what the congressional polls are.
And that's
you will
in the
see
toilet.
Congress. Yeah, exactly. They're just that Congress is just abysmal polling record. So basically, he'll say it's Congress's fault. The reason we haven't done something dramatic on guns, it's Congress's fault. Why isn't Congress backing the war against ISIL? Presidents tend to blame Congress and the press for things they're unable to get done. And I suspect President Obama's like all the others.
Mm-hmm. And overall, what do you think will comprise of the president's legacy? What will be his lasting mark?
Well, the economy. I mean, when he came in, we had the Great Recession. There was a feeling that our nation's financial systems were hemorrhaging. Here we are 7 years later, and there's just look at the Wall Street ticker tape or look at indexes for home prices, and unemployment has gone way down. So I think he's going to want to say, I pulled us out of the Great Recession. He can't say that yet in a true terms because he still has another year to go, and as we know, anything can happen. The economy bombed on George W. Bush in October of 2008, his last year. So first and foremost, the president has to keep this economy alive this year if he wants to be, you know, achieve one of these above average or outstanding legacies.
Mm-hmm. All right, Douglas Brinkley, Happy New Year. Good to see you. Thanks
hey,
so much.
Happy New Year. Thanks for having me. Take
All
care
right.
yourself.
Thank you. All right, still to come.